General John Fruin, Chief of Joint Operations, Lieutenant General Greg Bilton, Chief of Army, Lieutenant General Rick Burr, Chief of Navy, Vice Admiral Michael Noonan, Chief of Air New Zealand Air Force, Air Vice Marshal Andrew Clark, and representatives from the Diplomatic Corps. Distinguished guests, ladies and gentlemen, shortly, under the direction of Squadron Leader Dan Phillips, the Air Force Band will lead on the escort squadron with the cased Queen's colour for the Royal Australian Air Force. The escort squadron is provided by the Air Force Division of Australia's Federation Guard and aviators from Canberra-based units under the command of Flight Lieutenant Maxwell Moody. The colour bearer is Pilot Officer Nicola Mitchell, the Her Majesty the Queen's Gold Medal recipient. Colour Warrant Officer is Warrant Officer Andrew Garnett, the Air Force Headquarters Warrant Officer. Colour Escorts are Sergeant Mark Veering and Sergeant Bradley Ude from the Australian Federation Guard. And the Colour Orderly is Corporal Laura Pearson, the Enlisted Aviator of the Year. After the escort squadron is in position, the colour will be uncased and marched onto the parade. The parade host officer, Air Commodore Hayden Marshall, will greet the official guests. The incoming Chief of Air Force, Air Marshal Robert Chipman, and Mrs. Elise Chipman, and the outgoing Chief of Air Force, Air Marshal Mel Hupfeld, and Mrs. Lou Hupfeld, will then arrive to be received by the parade. A welcome to country will be offered by Ngunnawal Elder, Uncle Shane Halloran, accompanied by leading aircraftman Taryn Roach on the Yidiki. The Chief of Air Force will then be invited to inspect the escort squadron and the Air Force band. A flypast of aircraft will then occur. May I request at this point that all mobile phones be switched off or turned to silent until the completion of today's ceremony. Ladies and gentlemen, the escort squadron is now marching on. Thank you. The Queen's colour for the Royal Australian Air Force will now be uncased. Ladies and gentlemen, please stand for the royal salute to the Queen's colour for the Royal Australian Air Force. Members in uniform are to salute when point of war is played. Ladies and gentlemen, please be seated. The Chief of Defence Force, General Angus Campbell, will now be received by the parade. The incoming Chief of Air Force, Air Marshal Robert Chipman, will now be received by the parade. Chief of Air Force, Air Marshal Mel Hupfeld, will now be received by the parade. Ladies and gentlemen, a welcome to country is a significant ceremony performed by an elder to welcome visitors to their traditional land. Welcome to country is an ancient Aboriginal and Torres Strait Islander tradition that was practiced when a community sought permission to enter another nation's traditional land. Uncle Shane Halloran, the elder of the Ngunnawal people, will now offer a welcome to country.
Yuma. Yumulundi. Yangu, Ngalawiri, Dunimanyan. Ngunuwawari, Dawarawari. Hello and welcome. Today we're here on Ngunnawal country. Firstly, I acknowledge my ancestors and my elders, the Ngunnawal people who are the traditional custodians of the region encompassing Canberra, the ACT and surrounds. The Ngunnawal people pay our respects to our traditional neighbours, the Gadangada to the northeast, the Wagaloo to the south, the Wiradjuri to the west, the Yuin to the east, and the Ngarrigo to the southeast. As mentioned, it's believed that a welcome to country is an ancient Aboriginal protocol that ensures that once welcomed, your body and spirit are protected whilst on another's land. The Ngunnawal people welcome you and call on our ancestors to provide you a safe journey during your time on country. Injumara Daura, Injumara Ngunnawal Guda. We ask only that you respect the land, people, traditions here in Ngunnawal country. I'd like to acknowledge any Aboriginal and Torres Strait Islander people here today. I acknowledge Uncle Fred Monaghan and Justin Reed, Ngunnawal men, Chief of Defence Force Angus Campbell, Air Marshal Mel Hupfeld, current Chief of Air Force, incoming Chief of Air Force, Air Marshal Robert Chipman, and distinguished guests. I'd also like to acknowledge and pay my respects to all elders, leaders, both Indigenous and non-Indigenous, whose knowledge and experience hold so much value guiding our modern society as we shape an inclusive future for all people in all countries. As always in my welcomes, I like to speak about the Ngunnawal language. Today, I'd like to speak about one word that I commonly use, which is Yinjumara. It's a word commonly translated to be from Ngunnawal to English to mean respect, but it's more accurately defined as a lifestyle philosophy of respect and harmony, traditionally with the land, with the environment, and with the people around you. I chose this word for today because on behalf of the elders, I want to put a thank you to Air Marshal Hupfeld for the centenary of Air Force. Air Marshal delivered some of his speech in Ngunnawal, which meant so much to the Ngunnawal people. So I thank you for the time and respect you showed our people and for the positive impact that it's had on our community. Yumulundi, Galambani, Gajali Yinjumara, Winangay, Naraganawali. Welcome as we respectfully come together to look, listen and learn for the well-being of others. Thank you.
Thank you, Uncle Shane. The Yadiki will now be played by leading aircraftman Taryn Roach. Out. Distinguished guests, ladies and gentlemen, Air Marshal Hupfeld will now inspect the escort squadron and the band. Ladies and gentlemen, Air Marshal Hupfeld will now address the parade.
How do you hear there? That sounds a little better. Darura Nuna, Darura Nunawal. Yangu Nala Wiri, Duni Manyan. Nunawal Wari, Darura Wari. This is Nunawal country, and today we meet on Nunawal country. I acknowledge the traditional custodians of this land, and I pay my respects to their elders, past, present, and emerging. And my thanks to Uncle Shane. Great working with you, and what an inspiring and meaningful welcome accompanied by Taryn. Truly, truly amazing. Naragana Wali Munyan, Gulumbunya, Yinjumara Jin Yin. We are coming together respectfully. Yuwal Warinu, Bijajima Warinu, Yarabinga Yanbi. Bijajimanu, Nunalunja, Garagang Ninga. I continue in the footsteps of those who came before us, and in time I will pass our Air Force to the next chief and those who will follow us. Distinguished guests, ladies and gentlemen, together with my lovely wife, Lou, we wish you a very sincere, chilly, and now very wet welcome to this handover parade. We're both very humbled and certainly honoured that you would join us through this adversity for this really important ceremony. And I guarantee I'm accountable for us being here in the rain, so you can solely blame me, but boy, have we thrown the gauntlet down for the army parade to follow. So Lou and I, we've had, you know, I think you would say a rather unusual tenure as the role of the Chief of Air Force, with markedly the challenge of COVID and certainly a very significantly evolving strategic environment. We are extremely proud of how our Air Force has responded and certainly delivered during this dynamic period. And I feel that with these unexpected challenges, we've experienced an actually unique but rewarding tenure, and it's been one that we've truly enjoyed. These challenges didn't define our resolve, and our achievements have been due to your collective resilience, commitment, and passion to our purpose in defence of this nation. To my One Defence colleagues, now with the continuity of leadership through the Chief of Defence and the Purple Nine, through the public service leadership, through the Secretary and my Band 3 colleagues, I thank you all for the contest of ideas, the very frank contest of ideas, the support for our mission and the committed professionalism. And I believe that this is the strongest team that I've had the privilege to serve with in my time in senior defence appointments. To my service chief colleagues, we've worked hard to build an integrated force, and together I believe that we are handing over three services that are in good shape and certainly on the right path to achieving that objective. Our successes will bring new vision, new energy, and new commitment. To Mike and Rick, I thank you for your friendship and your trust. To our international partners, with Air Vice Marshal Andrew Clark, my friend and colleague from and counterpart from New Zealand here today, and to others represented by our defence attachés, you are essential to how we achieve our engagements, our relevance, and our strategic outcomes. Also acknowledge our other government agency partners and the importance of our engagement for the work that we do need to do together. To our industry representatives, I emphasise our essential reliance on your partnership, a strong partnership, and the need for your contribution to our key capabilities. To Air Marshal Rob Chipman and Elise, Lou and I offer our sincere congratulations and best wishes to you both as you step into this role as the Chief of Air Force. We have the greatest confidence in your ability and passion for the role, and we trust in your belief in our Air Force and your depth of experience to bring our key capabilities and people forward as part of an integrated force. To Warrant Officer Fee Grasby and my Air Force executive and the leadership team, and to our Air Force, represented by you, Soggily, on parade today. We have achieved much in the last 3 years. We've carried the ball well forward from the strong position that we received it 3 years ago. Lou and I were privileged to be in this role, and when we all celebrated the centenary of Air Force, a proud and very poignant moment within my service career and in my role as the Chief of Air Force. Marking that milestone certainly drove home how far our Air Force has come and the sacrifices that have been made to get here. I've witnessed an increase in female representation in our Air Force, now above our target of 25% and continuing to increase. An Aboriginal and Torres Strait Islander representation at 2.9%. I'm very proud of the diversity and capability enhancements that these achievements represent. I'm very proud of the continued transition to a more capable, agile, networked, integrated and potent 21st century Air Force. This includes retirement of the Air Combat Warhorse, the Classic Hornet, and a transition to the F-35, supported by an impressive air combat system of Growler, Super Hornet, Wedge Tail, command and control systems and sensors. And I've been able to witness the development and the first flight of the MQ-28A Ghostbat, the maturation of our P-8 fleet, progress in a coordinated approach to our hypersonics program, and the evolution of our integrated air and missile defence program from a concept to an opportunity that can be realised as a world-class system. And of course, the formal launch of Defence Space Command on the 22nd of March this year. That clearly demonstrates our recognition of space as an operational domain that is absolutely critical to our warfighting capability across all domains. Throughout our Air Force has continued to and executed many operations, both domestically and abroad, continuously operating and quietly getting on with business. An example of this dedication and discipline is through our Air Mobility Group COVID-19 statistics. 113 years of combined isolation, with 250 days of isolation being the highest for an individual, and zero COVID cases contracted during those missions. And another example, the Afghan evacuation, as a whole of government, whole of ADF effort, strongly executed with air power capability in the air and on the ground. And yes, these are good systems that we operate, but it is all of you, supported and enabled by family and friends who have delivered time and again. As a Chief of Air Force, I could not be prouder. But there's still much to do, and I'm pleased with the platform and the vector that we have set for Air Force for you to continue into our second century. And I'm ready now and excited to pass these tasks and these challenges to Air Marshal Chipman and the new leadership team, and for their work with our defence leadership. With the standard of personnel in Air Force and in the Australian Defence Force, and your skills and your continued commitment, all bodes well for the certain challenges of the future. From Lou and I, quite simply, thank you. Per ardua ad astra.
Thank you so much, sir. Ladies and gentlemen, would you please welcome Principal Air Chaplain James Cox, who will now offer a prayer of thanks.
Well, good afternoon. It's a great honour to lead this prayer of thanksgiving. My prayer offered today is through my Christian tradition, but I want to invite you to hold my words within your own respective faith or religious affiliation, or whatever is true for you. Let's pray. Eternal God, we thank you for this day and for this ceremony that brings us together, reminding us not only of the strength of our Air Force, but also the freedoms we enjoy as Australians. We thank you for our great country and your providential care over us since time immemorial. Today we give thanks for the gifts that lie within our human journey, the gifts of leadership, wisdom, and vision. We pray for this ceremony today that your presence will be with us as we take time to give thanks for our outgoing chief, Air Marshal Mel Hupfeld. Loving God, we thank you for the diligent and faithful leadership of Air Marshal Hupfeld. We thank you for the wise leadership he has brought to the role and the modernisation effected under his watch. We especially give thanks for the direction and strategic settings he has presided over to enable us to defend our nation, our people, and our values. We give much thanks for this legacy. Loving God, we recognise the sacrifice that comes with such a high calling to lead. We give thanks for Air Marshal Hupfeld and Mrs. Lou Hupfeld in their support of one another and the generous spirit in which they have served. Loving God, we ask your blessing on the Hupfelds as they prepare to embrace this new season before them. May their best years be yet to come, and may they know your loving presence travels with them. Loving God, we ask your blessing on our new chief, Air Marshal Robert Chipman, that as he executes his new command and responsibilities, he will do so with wisdom, courage and strength, supported by Elise and their four sons. We pray your blessing on this family. Lord, as we witness this important leadership handover, would you speak into our hearts? May we each rededicate ourselves in our service to our nation. May we dedicate ourselves afresh to the cause of freedom and the pursuance of justice in our world. May we be empowered by your grace as we do so. Gracious God, we give thanks for all that you do for us both in and out of harm's way. Keep each of our aviators and family members here today safe and rejoicing always in the freedom and values in which we share. In your precious name we pray. Amen.
Thank you, Principal Air Chaplain Cox. Ladies and gentlemen, Warrant Officer of the Air Force, Fee Grasby, will now present the Chief of Air Force Distinguishing Flag to Air Marshal Hupfeld. Ladies and gentlemen, Air Marshal Sir Richard Williams is considered the father of the Royal Australian Air Force and served as the first Chief of the Air Staff. Today, Air Marshal Hupfeld will continue the tradition commenced at his own change of command ceremony by presenting Air Marshal Chipman with the original sword worn by Sir Richard Williams. The sword was chosen as it signifies the passing of responsibility from one Chief of Air Force to the next. Assisting with the handover, aide-de-camp to the Chief of Air Force, Flight Lieutenant Tegan Corley, and one of the newest members of the Air Force, aircraftman recruit Matthew Jackson from One Recruit Training Unit. Distinguished guests, ladies and gentlemen, Air Marshal Hupfeld will now be accorded his final salute as Chief of Air Force.
This is going to be
Ladies and gentlemen, could I please ask you to stand while Air Marshal Hupfeld and Mrs. Hupfeld depart the parade. Ladies and gentlemen, Chaplain Yossi Friedman will now offer the invocation.
It is with great honour and humility that I stand before you today to recite this special prayer of induction. I will then follow by sounding the shofar, the ram's horn, and you can read about its significance on the last page of your service booklet. The invocation prayer. Almighty God, when the biblical King Solomon was tasked with leading a nation, you asked him what blessing he would like to receive. He asked for wisdom, and that request was granted. The ancient Jewish sages describe wisdom as the power to foresee the consequences of one's choices and actions. And as we stand here today, at the induction of our new chief of the Royal Australian Air Force, we ask you, Almighty God, to bless Air Marshal Robert Chipman and his leadership team with that same wisdom. The wisdom to lead a capable team of women and men with courage and with a commitment to truth and peace. Supreme God, guide Air Marshal Robert Chipman and Elise in taking up this new role and adjusting to new responsibilities. Almighty God, bless, protect, and watch over him as he goes about his daily tasks, both at home and overseas. Grant him success in all of his endeavors, and may his service bring blessing to all those that he serves. In this technological age, may Air Marshal Robert Chipman harness new capabilities to keep our country safe and preserve the precious ideals that we all share. May he bring out the best in the people whom he commands and project a clarity of vision that will unite and inspire. Bountiful God, may the words of the holy priests that served in Solomon's temple be fulfilled. Yivarechecha Adonai v'yishmerecha. May God bless you and may he keep you. Ya'er Adonai panav elecha v'chuneka. May God's face shine towards you and be gracious to you. Yissa Adonai panav elecha v'yasem lecha shalom. May God raise his countenance upon you and bestow upon you peace. Amen.
Thank you, Chaplain Friedman. In Jewish tradition, the ram's horn, which is called a shofar, contained significance for the Chief of Air Force change of command ceremony, as it was historically sounded at the coronation of a new king or leader of eminence to instill awe and reverence into the hearts of the people. Ladies and gentlemen, a warm welcome to Air Marshal Chipman, who will now deliver his address.
Good afternoon, Chief of Defence Force General Angus Campbell and our former CDS, Air Chief Marshal Sir Angus Houston and Mark Pinskin. Distinguished guests, family, friends, aviators. Thank you for all being here today to mark the transfer of command of our Air Force. It's a momentous occasion for my family and I. I am both honoured and deeply humbled to be selected as your new Chief of Air Force. I would like to start by acknowledging the traditional custodians of the land on which we meet, the Ngunnawal people. I pay my respects to their elders, their continuing culture, and the contribution they make to the life of our nation. I also wish to acknowledge the First Nations people who serve with pride and distinction in the Royal Australian Air Force. 33 years ago, as a second year cadet at the Australian Defence Force Academy, I failed an eyesight test and was told to find an alternate career. The Commandant at ADFA at the time was an accomplished fighter pilot and an exceptional leader. Air Vice Marshal Dick Bomble backed his convictions, challenged bureaucracy, and arranged a waiver on my behalf. Dick is here today. I'm honoured that you could join us. Thanks very much, sir. I would like to acknowledge the exceptional leadership and substantial contribution Mel Hupfeld has made to our Air Force, in particular over the last 3 years. His passion and humility through Air Force's centenary celebrations, his leadership through COVID-19, his advocacy of the Defence Space Command, and perhaps most significantly, his determination to shift our culture irreversibly to put joint, integrated, policy-led air and space power at the core of our organisation's purpose. They have all left an indelible mark on our Air Force. Lou has been a brilliant wingman supporting Mel with dignity, empathy and grace. We've been extremely well served by our service chiefs over many decades. Mel and Lou join them today, having upheld our proud heritage and strengthened our foundations for the future. On behalf of all aviators, I express my sincere gratitude to their superb service. We look now to our future and a strategic environment that will no doubt continue to present challenges and conundrums. With intensifying great power competition, accelerating climate change and technological development, and increasing economic pressure, our circumstances will demand more of us, more quickly than we anticipated. But I am confident that we will prevail. I now command an Air Force with great traditions of shaping our environment, deterring aggression and coercion, and responding with extraordinary courage, dedication, and skill in peace and in war. We will continue to generate air power and space power to enable the joint force, ready to protect our sovereignty and exercise our rights under international law. We will strengthen our resilience, expediting capability and preparing to fight through the disruptions and dislocations of modern or domain conflict. And we'll remain resourceful, making space for innovation and creativity to optimize our performance while taking full advantage of emerging technology. These are my priorities: ready, resilient, resourceful. It's not a transformation for Air Force. Mel and his predecessors have set us on the right vector. Our Air Force strategy guides the development of an integrated air and space power employed by intelligent and skilled workforce actively engaged across the department, across government, with allies and our partners, industry and academia, demonstrating our culture and values with streamlined governance arrangements that put focus back on our tradecraft. I'm committed to our Air Force strategy and I intend to pursue it with urgency. I am committed too to optimising the performance of our aviators. You are our most precious resource and our most decisive advantage. I want all of us to feel as inspired by our experience of work as we are by our purpose and achievement. That means maintaining a work environment that is safe, inclusive and supportive, and it means being accountable to each other for preserving that environment. Finally, I would like to extend my thanks to our wider Air Force community, acknowledging the demands that service life places on our families, but importantly too, the crucial role they play in supporting our aviators to achieve our mission. I of course include among you Elise, Tom, Ollie, Darcy and Charlie, with a special call out to Darcy, who unfortunately cannot be with us today. But they share the same sense of excitement today that I feel, and perhaps a little bit of trepidation. Per ardua ad astra. Thank you.
Thank you, sir. The Warrant Officer of the Air Force, Fee Grasby, will now order the hoisting of the Chief of Air Force Distinguishing Flag. This flag will fly in front of Russell officers during Air Marshal Chipman's tenure as the Chief of Air Force. Air Marshal Chipman will now be accorded his first general salute as Chief of the Royal Australian Air Force. Ladies and gentlemen, would you please stand for the departure of Air Marshal and Mrs. Chipman? Ladies and gentlemen, please remain standing for the departure of the Chief of Defence Force, General Angus Campbell. Ladies and gentlemen, please remain standing for the departure of the Queen's Colour for the Royal Australian Air Force, the Escort Squadron and the Air Force Band. Ladies and gentlemen, that concludes the Royal Australian Air Force Change of Command ceremony. Thank you so much for coming today. May you have a warm and dry afternoon, everyone. Thank you.